today I'm very happy because I am with Germain Lindsay to talk about the Invisible Sentinel solution at a more expert level, because last time it was with Ben, was basic. Remember the video?
If it's a high quality beer or not.
I'm so happy that you brought that up, Julian.
And you are an expert.
I am an expert. I like to consider myself an expert.
I'm sure you are.
Ben is definitely an expert in a lot of topics, but sometimes in the beer, I have a little bit more information to offer.
Okay.
You don't want to go for a ride, do you? We could get out of the palace, see the world.
Is it safe?
Sure, do you trust me?
So, last time I understood that your solution is really easy, simple for every brewers. But I understood that you test the final product, so I thought, okay, what should I do with this result at the end? I have a pediococcus, for example, up resistant positive. What should I do?
Yeah, so I think, Julian, you bring up a good point, is we did not want to just provide a yes or no in terms of if there's a contamination at the brewery. I think what we also wanted to do was provide a quantitative result to understand the severity of the issue as well. So okay. Aside from the fact that we're specifically detecting hop-resistant lactobacillus or pediococcus, meaning it can survive in the beer in the first place and potentially threaten its quality, we wanted to be able to give the brewers a better idea of the risk that the detected organism presents to their product as well.
Imagine that I have a lot of lactobacillus inside my beer.
Yeah.
So I throw it away, or I can do something else?
Yeah, not necessarily. Yeah, I think that we're able to obviously test the brewery's finished product. That can be in the package before it ships to avoid a messy recall situation. That can also be
That's a good point.
Yeah, it could also be in the actual tank before it goes to package to even avoid wasting any packaging materials or labor hours from the packaging team at the brewery as well.
Mm-hmm. Can I test before the final product in the process?
Absolutely.
That's what I want to know, because you mentioned that finally I can test my raw material, I can test everything.
What? Yeah, absolutely. So really what we're trying to do is provide a tool that's not just compatible with the finished beer product, because that is a very valuable stage of the process to test. We also want to be able to give a little bit more proactive testing upstream in the production process as well.
Okay.
Our tests are compatible with fermentation samples. Our tests are compatible, as you mentioned, with the actual raw materials, so testing the yeast. And we could even test the environment, whether that's surfaces of different equipment or rinse water from cleaning cycles.
How do you do it for the environment? I mean, because the sample for beer, it's liquid, but for when you are testing a surface, how do you do
so
it?
For these applications, we actually took a lot of our best practices and know-how from our food safety side of the business, where people are constantly planning for plant audits and HACCP planning, et cetera. So what we actually use is just a sterile surface sponge, which is able to swab areas like filler heads on a packaging line, manways on a tank, or all the way even up to the brew house at the heat exchanger, to see if indeed these problems are stemming from different equipment and potentially shadows in their sanitation process.
Mm-hmm. If you have three advice for me in my process, what should I test?
Yeah.
Raw material, pediococcus? No, not really.
Yes, actually. So I think that the smartest idea for any brewery that's just getting started with testing at their brewery on site is definitely using our BrewPal product to test for bacteria early on in fermentation. And the reason for this is, since we sell a proactive technology, we also want to take a quality assurance stance in making sure that even from the beginning of production, that your beer is free of any contaminants that could be competing with your yeast, for example, or free of any contaminants like diastaticus early on in fermentation. That way you're not allocating a ton of resources, time, ingredients towards something that may already be lost in terms of contamination. So one of the ideal spots that I recommend is using BrewPal and our BrewStat test for both hop-resistant lactobacillus and pediococcus, and also Saccharomyces diastaticus in the fermentation tank.
Okay.
And this way, it kind of acts as a check for the lot that's being produced in the tank, but it's also checking to make sure that that yeast that they're going to harvest out of the tank is not contaminated for the next batch of beer that they brew afterwards as well. A lot of our customers are using our Veriflow system because it's well suited for almost any size of craft brewery. Mm-hmm. Some larger breweries have higher throughput in terms of samples and also have some needs that may be outside of the spoiler spectrum as well. So as a result, we've been able to team up with BioMaryU and offer our new BrewPro test kit on the GeneUp real-time light cycler as well. Yeah.
So yes, multiplexing, real-time PCR, so a lot of opportunities.
You got it. Yeah, so it's the next step. It's the upgrade. But I think we'll have a chance to talk more about that maybe in the next episode.
Thank you very much for your time.
It's a pleasure, Julien. Thank you.
And see you in Lyon.
Absolutely.
Bye.
À la prochaine.
À la prochaine.